On January 26, 2024, President Biden announced a pause on pending approvals of liquefied natural gas, or LNG, export terminals. You might have heard other politicians or people from the fossil fuel industry accuse Biden of helping the Russians and letting poor Americans freeze to death while drowning puppies. You might wonder, what is this all about? If so, then you're in the right place. The pause on permits for LNG export terminals is to allow time for the Department of Energy to update the approval process to consider the impact the export terminals will have on the U.S. energy markets and the global environment. This has no impact on currently operating export terminals or those that are under construction, just those that are seeking permits. And the fossil fuel industry and the politicians who serve them are on a PR campaign to just make things up. I'm Andy Silber, and this is Decarbonize. Here I'm going to go through a short video of Republican House Majority Leader Steve Scalise lying on Fox News. I acknowledge there's a possibility he's just really clueless, but I suspect that he knows what he's saying isn't true and he doesn't care. A quick description of what LNG is. Due to fracking, the U.S. production of natural gas has grown to greatly exceed our needs. Typically, it's transported by pipeline, but then the U.S. can only export to Canada and Mexico, neither of which has much demand. To get to global markets, it must be cooled to minus 165 degrees Celsius, where natural gas becomes a liquid. This happens at specialized port facilities or terminals, and then it's put onto specialized ships, where it's taken to a different kind of port to regasify the liquid and inject it into the pipeline system of the destination country. It takes 3 to 5 years to build one of these ports once all the permits are in place. So what light will Majority Leader Scalise shed on the Biden administration's actions?
Joining me right now is House Majority Leader, Louisiana Congressman Steve Scalise. Leader Scalise, thanks so much for being here this weekend.
Always great to be with you, Maria. Thanks for having me.
And you know all the details. Louisiana is an energy state. What is your reaction to the president putting a pause on these LNG deals?
Well, this is another classic example of President Biden bowing to the far extreme left to appease TikTok influencers.
According to a poll by the Pew Center, 56% of Americans believe that the federal government is doing too little to combat climate change. This is not an issue just of TikTok influencers, but considering climate change is something that most Americans believe should happen, and more. This pause gives the DOE time to incorporate climate considerations into their permitting process.
At the expense of hardworking families, this will raise energy costs in America.
This is probably the most bald-faced lie. Actually, the opposite is true. Basic supply and demand. If the fossil fuel companies are able to export natural gas, the supply in the U.S. will decrease, and that will raise prices. The reason they want to build these terminals is to sell where the prices are higher. That's why one of the changes the Biden administration wants is to consider the impact on U.S. energy markets.
And by the way, are those TikTok influencers banning the use of natural gas amongst themselves? Do they even know how many different products use natural gas? Do they know that natural gas allowed America to lower our carbon emissions, if that's their holy grail that they seem to want to die on?
There's nothing in this pause that reduces the supply of natural gas in the U.S. And what does he have against TikTok influencers?
All they're going to do is embolden our enemies.
I'm guessing this refers to Russia. Since the invasion of Ukraine, exports of natural gas from Russia to Europe have plummeted, and much of the replacement has been American LNG. There were fears that taking Russian oil and gas off the market would spike worldwide prices, but that hasn't been the case. Prices increased briefly, but the market recovered for three reasons. One, there was a mild winter in Europe, so consumption was lower than usual. Two, U.S. LNG was able to fill the gap. And three, the EU accelerated its decarbonization process, building a record amount of wind production in 2022 and 2023. Renewables are now responsible for over 40% of the electricity generated in the EU, and it's growing. Over time, it's likely the EU will no longer be interested in U.S. LNG as renewables increase their role. The U.S. is the largest exporter of LNG. Nothing in the pause will reduce the amount we export. It just slows the increase in the amount we export. So unless the war in Ukraine lasts for 10 years, this pause will have no bearing on standing up to our enemies. And renewables are the fastest growing source of energy everywhere. So in 10 years, our current LNG terminals might not even be working at capacity.
Embolden foreign countries that are going to now be supplying the natural gas that we would have otherwise been supplying to our allies around the world. We do it cleaner than anywhere in the world.
I couldn't find any data on this, but given that most U.S. natural gas comes from fracking, this is very unlikely to be true.
These people love beating up America every day. They will never acknowledge all the great benefits that come from America being able to produce our own energy, because if we don't produce our energy, we're going to end up getting it from other countries that don't have the standards we do, and that hurts our economy, it hurts our energy security. But President Biden doesn't care. As long as he gets these TikTok influencers to help him in his reelection, he doesn't care if it hurts the economy.
One of the changes in the review process Biden is calling for is to include the impact on increasing exports on our economy. Cheap natural gas has been a boon economically. I'm not saying it's worth trashing our environment, but if all you care about is the U.S. economy, keeping the natural gas trapped here helps. Who it hurts are the fossil fuel companies who make more money selling it to higher bidders abroad.
It's why he's doing so bad in the polls, because the public's fed up with this kind of bad policy.
Yeah, I mean, do you think these young TikTokers understand that this is not just an energy and economic issue, but a national security issue?
Of course not. I mean, are they riding bicycles? Yeah. No, they're probably driving around in cars, and maybe even if they're driving around in an electric car, do they not know? They don't plug that car into a tree, Maria.
Right.
They have to plug it into some source that's probably generated by fossil fuels, natural gas.
Yeah.
They'll never want to admit it, but that's what the reality is.
The U.S. is the world's largest producer of oil and gas. As we move to renewables, it's unlikely we will ever again be a significant importer of fossil fuel. Natural gas is currently the largest source of energy on our electrical grid, but almost all new power plants are renewables, as we can see in this graph from the Energy Information Agency. But this is irrelevant in any case, because Biden's action is about exporting natural gas, not its use domestically. What's happening here is the fossil fuel industry wants to maximize their profits, and they don't care about the U.S. economy or the health of people or the planet. And they are happy to send their proxies like Steve Scalise out to lie about it. Speaking of, as a fan of efficiency, I do need to give him credit. Hitting 7 lies in less than 2 minutes is an impressive performance. Only TikTok influencers care about the environment. This pause will increase energy prices in the U.S. This action will impact Americans' access to natural gas. This will embolden our enemies. Our natural gas is the cleanest in the world. If we don't produce our own energy, we're going to import it from other countries, and Biden doesn't care about the economy. The time to stop building infrastructure to support fossil fuel consumption has long since passed. The billions of dollars spent building these terminals and ships that have no other use but to move fossil fuels that we can't afford to burn should be spent on accelerating the decarbonization path that we're on. If you see a lie I missed, please mention it in the comments. And as always, please like and subscribe.